Howdy, everyone. Organizations are embracing Gen AI and RAG models and agentic systems. With that, we're starting to see a lot of challenges pop up. One of the challenges we're seeing is how do we propagate an identity across an agentic flow? And we really want to kind of dig into this now and see in agentic systems, how are we going to securely propagate identities? To do this, we need to start and step back a little bit and look at kind of how we've evolved in identity propagation. Let's start with our user. And let's say that they're connecting to a database or some sort of system, something that they want to communicate with. We'll put a little application in here. So a user has to connect to that and it connects off to this system. So this will be our first pattern that we want to start with. Now, as we go through this, we're going to look at a set of delegation patterns. And these are the patterns, all the different patterns that exist that we want to kind of use. The first one we're going to look at is no delegation. Now, what this really says is that we have a user, they're going to connect to this application. The application is going to connect to the database on its own. It has a secure connection or some sort of transaction set up here, and it doesn't know anything about the user. It doesn't need to know about the user. You connect, you return some information. That is what we call basically no delegation. The next thing we want to look at is what we call trusted assertion. Now, we're going to start getting into the thought of, well, who is the user? This is really starting to get into identity propagation. So we're likely going to have an IDP. So this is an identity provider. The user comes in, they authenticate against this system, and then that is used to tell the database who that user is. So that user is going to have some sort of privilege out here. And we want to use that. Now, in the case of trusted assertion, it's still this connection that we had before. The system and the database have some sort of credential passing, whatever it is they're using to make that connection. And I'm going to assert who the user is. And this can be an SAML assertion. There's different ways to do this. But basically, I will make the connection. I will pass that identity of the user into the database so I can check their privilege and return the right things. There's another model of this that we will look at, another pattern that is simple delegation. Now, in simple delegation, basically it's the same kind of thing. Instead of asserting who the user is, I'm going to come in, I'm going to authenticate myself, I'm going to create a token, that token gets passed back, and this becomes what I'm using for privilege. So as we look at our challenges, what we're really trying to look at is one, how are we propagating this identity? The next challenge is what can the user do? And this really says, what am I allowed to access? What actions am I allowed to take? All right, so this is great. This kind of brings us up to where we're at in our systems today. But now let's start introducing agentic. So let's say that we're interfacing with a chatbot out front. And that's our first interaction. And then maybe that goes to a router, and then that goes to another agent. So now we've introduced an agentic flow. There are multiple nodes and hops. And let's say, just to keep this going, that we check here with our identity provider. We authenticate ourselves. Here is who I am. Get my identity. And then we want to propagate that identity through the system. So when we start thinking about what are the challenges, what are the problems with this, what happens then if we have a bad actor who actually creates some agent or system on their own, and they connect here to the router, and they pass in an identity? They actually start impersonating you. So this is Edwina Cutwater impersonating Roger Cobb and wants to be able to take whatever privileges that that user has and propagate it through. So if we're just merely propagating the identity from the starting point in, how do we prevent that somebody inserts and says, hey, I am the identity of this person, and now please give me back all the stuff that we want to, that that person would be entitled to retrieve. So this really then starts talking about our next challenge, which is really then, how do we trust the identity? In other words, how does this agent down in this flow, or an agent up in this flow, or any flow that is created, how does it know? It has no visibility to where this user came in and originally authenticated themselves. How do they trust that the identity that is coming through the system is actually the identity that is supposed to be used, and the privileges and the data, whatever it is that we're trying to protect, is actually going back to the person that we think it is? So that becomes our next challenge, is how do we really then from these systems trust the identity? I'm going to introduce now another delegation pattern, which is on behalf of delegation. Now this starts getting into a model where we have an agent and a user. Both of them are going to have identities. They're both going to be part of, they're going to have tokens, they're going to have privilege, they're going to have rights. Now the agent is going to work on behalf of the user. And the user trusts that agent, it knows who this agent is, and it trusts it to act on your behalf. Now, what happens if we have multiple agents? What happens if in agentic flow that's very dynamic and agents get introduced into the system? How does the user then know to trust all the agents down throughout the system? And this really starts introducing yet another challenge, is how do we have a user accept transitive trust? In other words, the user is not actually trusting an individual agent. What they're doing is they're trusting the system to act and behave on their behalf. All right, I'm going to introduce one final now pattern here, and this is multiple IDPs, identity providers. So what this really looks like then is, let's say that this is all a system here. This is a company. This is an organization. Let's say this is company A, and we have another organization. We'll call this company B. And we're actually talking across organizational boundaries. This could even be within divisions if things are really separated within a company. But the point is we now have separate identity providers within these two organizations. We may even have, as we cross over boundaries, another router that figures how to send an agentic flow to get a prompt and a response. But now we have to deal with the independent ID providers and independent systems. And so we have to cross this. So these are the patterns and the challenges that we are really seeing emerging, especially around identities and identity propagation in organizations. And so let's start thinking about what are our strategies then to how to deal with this. Now, of course, this is an emerging space. It's an emerging world. The strategies I'm going to outline here will work, but they will also evolve as we start evolving agentic systems. So the first thing that we really want to look at as a strategy is we really want to use OAuth 2 and OIDC, OpenID Connect. So this really says, let's stick to the standards. We have standards on how to identify users and what the rights and privileges are. Let's use that as our common base for talking. This works really well if we have company A talking to company B. They both operate on industry standards. That makes it very easy to do this interaction. So first thing we want to do is use OAuth 2 and OIDC as our standards. The next thing we want to do is introduce a concept of a token exchange. Now, what this is really saying is that at each node along an agentic flow, we actually want to go back to the IDP and we want to do an exchange of the ticket. So we started with an original token or a token. We started with an original token here and we flow that token through. But each hop, we actually want to go exchange that token. And this way, we can really start looking at How do we validate that the user is the right user? And really what this is starting to say is, if you remember back here, we had this kind of a secure connection between this application and the database, and we understood that connection. Now, when we think about an agentic flow, it is an established flow. We know endpoints. We know each hop in, along the way. If at each hop, we evaluate and look at to make sure that the incoming endpoint, the outgoing endpoint that we know are all the correct ones, we can exchange our token to make sure it works for that hop. So that way we can start preventing, you know, people from coming and impersonating and injecting themselves into the flow, because it would not match our known flow and it would not match our known endpoint. So we can start eliminating that. So what it really kind of does then for us is it verifies our identity. And it establishes trust. We can even do this across company organizations as well. Same kind of establishment of trust. All right, so we do a token exchange. Next thing we want to do then, and this really starts playing into the OAuth2 concept, is we want to leverage context. We want to leverage scope. And we want to leverage audience. Now, this is really, really nice and important, because what this is saying is that we don't want the user at the very beginning of our agentic flow. We don't want to say that they can do anything across the entire company, across the entire enterprise. As they move along the nodes, as we have a context of the token that's moving through, we want to only allow them the scope, or what they're authorized to do, to be very narrow and really ultimately narrow down to just the access to this database. And along every node, we want to narrow that scope to what they're allowed to do along that process flow. The other thing, by adding audience, we can say when we do this token exchange that we know the next hop, and we say that is our audience. So when an agent somewhere in the flow receives an exchange token, it should see itself as the audience. It knows it has now taken the next action. If the audience is incorrect or non-existent, it knows to reject that out. So again, that starts preventing injections into this flow with impersonated identities. So we really want to leverage some of the capabilities and features that we're seeing in OAuth2. The next strategy we have is we want to connect our nodes, our agents, and our flow via APIs. So what this is really saying is we use API gateways. We understand APIs. We understand REST APIs. We understand API economies. We know that if we just pass connect through from one node to another along our agentic flow, and that goes through an API gateway, it's that gateway now that can have the responsibility of doing the token exchange. It's actually the thing that's going and exchanging the token. That takes the burden off of the developers, so they don't have to understand token exchanges. It also centralizes, at least within an organization, how we're going to do the token exchange. So it brings a lot of value to how we perform these strategies, or how we execute on these strategies. The final thing, and this is something we always want to do, is monitor. You know, when we start talking about compliance and security across the board, we always want to monitor what is happening across that agentic flow and make sure that the identity propagation is actually behaving the way we want. All right, so we know companies and organizations are embracing GenAI and agentic flows. We know that there is a challenge with how do you propagate that identity across that flow to make sure that it is securely being used and leverages. And I have presented a few strategies on how you can accomplish that. Thank you very much.